the hottest day of the summer in Nanjing. While most people stayed indoors, 73-year-old pensioner Yin Chunsheng and his friends braved the scorching heat to visit a museum.
I got up at 4 this morning and took the train from neighboring Anhui province, then took a taxi to here. I even wrote down the route to make sure I can find this place. The journey took me 3 hours, but it's absolutely worth it.
Portraits of 72 survivors from the 1937 Nanjing massacre are displayed at the entrance. Over 3,700 tokens of that time, including battle maps, photos, medals, video and literary archives, remind visitors of the history.
There are many touching items in the collections. For example, there's a painting of Nanjing by a Japanese painter which shows how beautiful the city was before the aggression and how ruined it was after. I've never seen such a comparison in other museums.
The museum was founded in 2006 by local businessman Wu Xianbing, who has invested close to $5 million over the years. Yet the museum is open for free. It's welcomed over 160,000 visitors so far, including many historians.
We collect objects from non-governmental channels, giving visitors a different perspective from official museums. Very few people heard of the museum in the beginning, but the visitors have gradually increased and been very satisfied to see more and more people coming here.
The museum also plays an important role in educating the younger generation by arranging seminars and school visits.
The paper cranes given by Japanese visitors impressed me the most. It shows that Japanese people want peace. Even though the Japanese army killed over 300,000 Nanjing residents during the war.
The museum is currently collecting accounts from war survivors and veterans, digitalizing them into oral archives.
History is the guide for the future. Thanks to places like this folk museum, the memories of this chapter in Chinese history will be passed on, ensuring peace will be preserved and cherished by generations to come. Lin Nan, CCTV, Nanjing, Jiangsu Province.